Welcome everyone. Let us study about clavipectoral fascia. To understand the concept of clavipectoral fascia, first let us see some of the structures in the pectoral region. Okay, this is a clavicle, it's a manubrium, it's a first rib. Okay, this muscle here, which is extending between the clavicle and the first rib, is the subclavius. We have made a model for the clavicle and the subclavius muscle attached on its inferior aspect. And this subclavius muscle gets inserted to that of the first rib. So that of the first rib. Then we can see this muscle. This is the pectoralis minor, which take origin from the second, third and the fourth rib and gets inserted into the coracoid process of scapula. Next, we have to know one more structure, which is the axillary sheath. This sheath, which is enclosing the axillary artery, is enclosing the axillary artery and the three cords of the brachial plexus, okay, and the cords of the brachial plexus are enclosed by the axillary sheath. Okay, this is passing behind the clavicle, okay, to enter inside the axilla. Okay, and at last, this is the axillary fascia. It's the axillary fascia. Okay, so knowing about all these structures, now we can understand the concept of clavipectoral fascia. All these structures will be visible only after we remove the pectoralis major. So the clavipectoral fascia is a fascia of fibrous sheath which is located deep to the pectoralis major muscle. Okay, deep to the pectoralis major muscle. This is a model of clavipectoral fascia. This fascia will be extending from the clavicle up to the axillary fascia. Okay, it will be extending from the clavicle up to the axillary fascia. See, the upper part will be splitting to enclose this muscle. This is the subclavius. Okay, it will be splitting to enclose the muscle, and the middle part will be splitting to enclose this muscle. This is the pectoralis minor. Okay, so this is the fascia. Its upper part splits into two lamina. You can see the upper part of the fascia splits into two lamina to enclose the subclavius. Okay, so this is the subclavius muscle. It will be enclosed by the split lamina of the upper part of the fascia. So subclavius is enclosed inside the upper split part of the clavipectoral fascia. The posterior lamina extends deep to that of the clavicle. See, the anterior lamina is fused with that of the undersurface of the clavicle. The posterior lamina extends inside the neck and it merges with the deep cervical fascia. Okay, it will be merging with that of the investing layer of deep cervical fascia, and also it will be merging with that of the axillary sheath. You can see here is the axillary sheath. It will be merging with that of the axillary sheath. That is about the posterior lamina. That is of the posterior lamina, which will be extending into the neck and fuses with that of the investing layer of deep cervical fascia and also the axillary sheath. Now coming to the lower part of the fascia, this is pectoralis minor. So it encloses the pectoralis minor by splitting into two laminas. Okay, by splitting into two laminas, lower part. Then it fuses to the posterior lamina. Then the anterior lamina fuses with the posterior lamina and converges and attaches to that of the axillary fascia. It will come and merge with that of the axillary fascia. Medially, the fascia is attached to the first rib. Okay, you can see the fascia is attached to the first rib and the costoclavicular ligament Laterally, it is attached to the coracoclavicular ligament. Okay, it is attached to the coracoid process and blends with the coracoclavicular ligament. This upper part of the fascia remains thick and it is called as the costocoracoid ligament. At last, we need to know about the structures piercing the clavipectoral fascia. The first structure, a nerve, the lateral pectoral nerve. The lateral pectoral nerve pierces the clavipectoral fascia and enters inside the pectoral region. Next is the cephalic vein. So this is the cephalic vein, which will drain the venous blood from the upper limb and drains into the axillary vein by piercing the clavipectoral fascia. It drains into the axillary vein by piercing into the clavipectal fascia. At last, the thoracoacromial vessels. So this is the thoracoacromial vessel which will be piercing the clavipectal fascia and entering inside the pectoral region. Okay, this is the thoracoacromial artery and the vein which will be entering through the clavipectal fascia. At last, along with these vessels, there will be the lymphatics. Okay, the lymphatics which will be passing from the breast and the pectoral region to that of the apical group of axillary lymph nodes. To that of the apical group of axillary lymph nodes will be passing through the clavipectal fascia. So these are the structures which pierce the clavipectal fascia. So what are the structures which pierce the clavipectal fascia? The lateral pectoral nerve, the thoracoacromial vessels, the cephalic vein, and some of the lymphatics will be piercing the clavipectoral fascia. If we take a section at this level, first we can draw the clavicle. Okay, first we can draw the cross section of clavicle. So this is the clavicle, this is the inferior aspect of the clavicle, this is the superior aspect of the clavicle. Okay, next we can draw the subclavius. In this section we can draw the subclavius muscle. So here will be the subclavius muscle. So this is the subclavius. Okay, so we have two laminas, the anterior lamina. So this is the anterior aspect, this is the posterior aspect, and the posterior lamina of clavipectal fascia. Then below that we have the clavipectal fascia extending downwards here. Okay, we're extending downwards. Then we have the pectoralis minor muscle which is cut here. So you can see this is the pectoralis minor which will be cut deep to the clavipectal fascia. That is the anterior lamina of the clavipectal fascia. So the anterior lamina here and the posterior lamina here. Okay, at last it will be ending in the axillary fascia. Okay, it will be ending in the axillary fascia. That is the axillary fascia. Now we can see these structures which are piercing at this level. So we can draw the piercing structures also. So the lateral pectoral nerve, the cephalic vein, and the thoracoacromial vessels, okay. So this is a section which is taken at this level to study the clavipectal fascia. Thank you.